We're seeing kind of this new era of really politicians that are extremely to the left, especially when it comes to gun control measures, like Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez from New York. She had been talking about reviving something like Operation Choke Point, which is they would go after banks and the financial institutions that deal with guns or manufacturers. What do Republicans do to push back against those ideas?
You know, we've got to fight them at every front. Going back to my days in the state house, where trial lawyers were trying to sue gun makers to bankrupt them, similar to what AOC is trying to do right now, because they know that gun control laws, their ultimate desire to take and confiscate guns from law-abiding citizens, is where they've always wanted to go. But they know the public's not there, the country's not there, so they try to go in back doorways and, you know, bankrupt the gun makers and bully and threaten and intimidate people. And we're not gonna be bullied. We're not gonna back down. We're gonna expose what they're trying to do. And frankly, ultimately, we're all held accountable. Everybody takes votes. And a lot of these members who ran saying that they were gonna be pro-gun are not. They're actually voting against our gun rights. And I think it's gonna cost them at the ballot box.
And what about the 2020 presidential candidates? We're seeing that they're embracing gun control more enthusiastically than ever. We have the presidential hopeful Eric Swalwell, who has suggested doing an AR-15 government buyback. So now we have billions of dollars to spend on guns, yet we don't have billions of dollars to spend on a wall, right? The Democrats say we don't have money. And also, how do you enforce that? That is, if they don't turn them in, are Americans jailed for owning guns?
They ultimately want to take and confiscate your guns. And look, I'm glad they're talking about this publicly, because the country needs to see what's at stake. You know, it used to be in the Democrat Party, you had moderates and liberals. Today, it's liberals and socialists. And frankly, the socialists are winning. And so as you watch this debate, I mean, look, Bernie Sanders the other day said that he wants the Boston Marathon bomber to be able to vote in elections from federal prison. His victims can't do that because they're dead. But he wants the bomber himself to be able to vote. And other candidates on the Democrat side are taking that same position. So I want them to keep talking about what they truly believe in, because they truly do believe in gun confiscation. Some of them say it publicly, some of them don't, but ultimately their actions are what matter. And that's where they want to go with this. And again, the American people are by and large a pro-Second Amendment and people that truly do believe that our rights to keep and bear arms are innate, not just for the militia, the army. The militia is every individual having the ability to defend themselves in their home. And that's where, you know, we need to continue to fight to preserve those rights.
And another idea from Swalwell was forcing gun owners to get insurance. And of course, there are insurance companies for guns. There are licenses, concealed carry, those type of things. But now this is just seems like it's another burden for law-abiding citizens. And maybe he's a little bit out of touch, but a lot of people don't have that type of extra money to spend just to own a gun that they've had maybe for even decades.
Right. You know, just like we don't charge people to vote, you shouldn't charge people to exercise their rights. I mean, obviously, if you want to go out and buy a gun, you have the ability and the right to go out and buy whatever gun is legally available. But to pay to exercise rights is something we don't do in this country and shouldn't do in this country. And again, anybody has the ability and the right to say whatever they want. The First Amendment allows you the ability to express your views, but at the end of the day, the American people will decide, do they want somebody who wants to take away your Second Amendment rights or any other rights? Because ultimately, when you see this move towards socialism, it's really about government control versus freedom. And so on so many fronts. I mean, obviously on gun rights, they want to take away your gun rights. They want to have the government controlling whether or not you can have a gun versus your freedom to do that. But they want to do that on health care as well. They want to do it on so many other fronts where they want the government to be telling you what you can and can't do. That's not where this country is. We're a free people. We're going to fight to defend those freedoms.